Hey everyone, thank you for watching. Today's video is going to be a new Will I Buy It. I post my Will I Buy It videos every single Wednesday where I'm talking about some new makeup releases and launches, letting you know a little bit about them, and then letting you know if I'm planning to pick them up or pass over them. Per usual, I have lots to chat about this week, so why don't we go ahead and get started. All right, I thought it was funny. I had my list ready to go, and then just this morning, all of a sudden, I kept getting tagged on this one specific product, and it wasn't even a newer post on the Trendmood One Instagram, which will be listed in the description box because I read a lot from her and sometimes use the photos and stuff, so I always have her listed. But all of a sudden, I kept getting posts on, it was something from 3 days ago, and all of a sudden, just this morning, and I'm like, What's going on here? And it's because it is a new release from Laura Geller, and I just mentioned Laura Geller in yesterday's video, which was 8 brands I want to try in 2018. So that video went up in the morning, and the next thing you know, a lot of you guys were tagging me on Instagram, which thank you, because I didn't even see this post. I didn't know that this release was out there. I completely missed it. So without your tags, I wouldn't even have known this was out there. So I decided to add this one in here instead just because of the number of posts that were coming in this morning. So Laura Geller is releasing a new Baked Gelato Swirl Illuminator Trio Palette. Okay, it is available now at Ulta Beauty. I did check, it is available on the site. It's $35 for 3 different shades, which is French Fizz, Pixie Pearl, and then Molten Copper. And these are the Baked Gelato Swirl highlights, which when I was talking about it in the 8 brands video, I was saying, you know, I kind of feel like I would mostly hear about the Laura Geller highlighters, especially the Gilded Honey. You know, everybody was always wearing Gilded Honey. So I just thought it was really interesting to see this new trio palette come out. And they look to be, you know, just a little bit smaller in size, I think, looking at the photos and comparing them to the, you know, the regular singles of the highlights. But, you know, obviously, even when you have a smaller highlight, it's still so hard to go through a single highlight. I don't think I've ever gone through a single highlight ever. I don't even know if I've hit pan on a single highlight. I mean, maybe for my highlights that shatter, but you know, does that really count? I don't think it does. So $35 for 3, I don't think is bad because I think for the one highlight, it's like $24. It's in like the mid 20 range for one single highlight, which is why I was saying in my brands video, like that's kind of why I didn't purchase them. Like I've had Gilded Honey in my hand before and I put it back because I thought it was too expensive. So I definitely did the double take when I saw the trio. I was like, wait a second. There's a really cool pink in there and a really cool, what looks to be like a gold highlight. But then there's one that looks, you know, probably that's going to be too dark for my skin tone. So I would probably really only be able to get 2 uses out of it. And I don't know, the pink, it's called Pixie Pearl, so it makes me think, you know, pearl, like a pinky pearl type of color, but I'm not 100% that would be my favorite. I feel like I've been more adventurous lately with my highlights. I know the, you know, iridescent trend is like really popping right now, and I was kind of like, ugh, I don't know if I would like that as a highlight, but I actually have been liking them a bit, but I still don't, I don't know for sure that all 3 I would really get a lot of use of. I'm not sure if it would be a great idea to buy a trio. So I think I'm gonna just hold off on this one for right now. I also am purchasing the Urban Decay highlight palette that I've been talking about. The Sephora sale, the 25 off 50 for Rouge members starts on Thursday, I think it is. So I really didn't feel like the Sephora Black Friday, Cyber Monday deals were all that crazy, so I didn't make a purchase from them then. But I just saw, actually Trendmood posted that the 25 off 50 is starting Thursday. So if you haven't seen that information yet, that is coming. I know a lot of you guys were asking me, wondering if that was gonna happen again, and that's what I'm going to buy, the Urban Decay highlight palette. So I know I have another highlight palette coming, so I don't think I need to purchase another one at this time, but thank you guys for the tags. That's awesome. I still think one of these days I'm gonna try me out some Gilded Honey, but for the trio for Laura Geller, I'm gonna go ahead and pass over it. So Maybelline recently just came out with a whole bunch of new items, and I was getting a lot of tags both on Instagram, also a lot of tags came in on Twitter. They just released a whole bunch of stuff. So I'm looking at the Ulta website. Looks like they came out with a few more colors of their Master Holographic Prismatic Highlighter, which is $9.99. They also came out with a new like kind of beauty blender. It's called the Face Studio Blender. So it's a makeup sponge for $5.99. They came out with a new Hydrate and Smooth Face Primer for $9.99. They came out with the Total Temptation Mascara, $9.49. Also the Total Temptation Eyebrow Definer Pencil, $7.99. They came out with new lipstick colors, which are $7.49. A new foundation, which I think the foundation was the one I was getting the most tags on. That's called the Super Superstay Full Coverage Foundation for $11.99. Also the Lasting Drama Light Eyeliner for $5.99. A Lip Studio Python Metallic Lip Kit for $9.99. The City Cheeks All-in-One Eye and Cheek Palette for $11.99. And also the Total Temptation Eyeshadow and Highlight Palette for $11.99. I think that was the second thing I was getting the most tags on. So I'll just kind of touch really briefly on these. The highlighter, I wouldn't purchase. I don't feel like I need it, you know, especially since I just said I was buying the Urban Decay. And I also have one of their, the like Master Chrome highlight. And honestly, I have to try it a few more times, but it's just not really my favorite. It doesn't really call to me. The Beauty Blender, I'm like somewhat interested in, but I just don't think I need it right now. I would need to throw away some of my other blenders before I really felt like I needed a new one. A primer, I just recently got a new primer that I love that I'll talk about in my makeup monthly, so I don't feel like I need a new primer. The mascara, don't need a new mascara. I recently did a mascara declutter and I still kept way too many mascaras. I did actually go ahead and order the Total Temptation Eyebrow Definer Pencil for $7.99. I don't know, it just looked interesting to me. I follow Maybelline on Snapchat and they do some tutorials, or like beauty influencers will do the takeovers on there and do tutorials. And I've seen a few using the eyebrow pencil and I just thought I would give it a try. I'm more comfortable with eyebrows lately. I was kind of a late bloomer with eyebrows, but I'm more comfortable with them now and I like trying out different things. I actually am trying out a new brow pencil to me on my eyebrows today, and I like trying new things and seeing, you know, what works for me and what doesn't work for me. And this one looks kind of similar to the Goof Proof, where it has like the teardrop shape tip. So I feel like I can get the hang of the Goof Proof pretty well, so we'll see how this one works. I think I want to do kind of like testing new drugstore makeup. I just got some things from e.l.f. and also Sleek Makeup, and so I thought I could get a couple of these Maybelline products. So I'll try out the eyebrow pencil coming up here shortly. Power Matte lipsticks. I don't feel like I need any lipsticks. I ordered some lipsticks as well. I will be doing like a Black Friday, Cyber Monday haul when I get all of my orders in. I ordered lipstick sets in there as well. So the Superstay Full Coverage Foundation for $11.99, I did go ahead and order that as well along with the eyebrow pencil, so I'll be trying that in, you know, the testing new drugstore makeup. I really like foundations. I'm kind of on a foundation kick right now, and I don't know, it just seemed interesting to me. Full coverage kind of scares me a little bit. Full coverage isn't like my absolute favorite. I'm more of like medium coverage, but I thought I could give it a try. I do like some of Maybelline's foundations. I really liked the Better Skin foundation, so I'm excited to try this one and just give it a try and see what it's like. $11.99, you know, I didn't think that was a bad price, and then I know I had like a $3.50 coupon that Ulta usually does, and I got 6% cash back at Ebates because I ordered on Black Friday, so that was awesome. So I figured I'd go ahead and give it a try. They were actually sold out of the color that I wanted, so I went with, I think, like a color lighter maybe, since we're approaching winter. So I was like, oh, maybe it'll work. I don't know. We'll see. But I did purchase that one, so we'll try it out pretty soon. The eyeliner, I'm not super interested in, and I have plenty of eyeliners. I also kept a lot in my eyeliner declutter. The metallic lip kit wouldn't be for me. I'm not a metallic lip person, and I'm also not like a lip kit, lip palette type of girl, so I would pass over that. The All-in-One Eye and Cheek Palette for $11.99. I'm going to pass over it. I'm just not really a fan of these palettes because, you know, Maybelline kind of had these with the Gigi Hadid collection too, where like each of the pan sizes are like really tiny, and I'm like, how do you put your brush in that? And I feel like, I don't know, I feel like things would kind of be going everywhere, and the powder would be going in the other powder, and I don't know. Some of the shades in there too, like, just don't really scream out at me, so I'm gonna pass over that one. The eyeshadow and highlight palette, it did catch my attention. I did a double takeover there, and I kind of considered, you know, should I purchase it along with the foundation and the eyebrow pencil, but I don't feel like it gave me a strong enough pull. Again, the pan sizes are small, so you would have to use like tiny brushes to get into the majority of them, but it just didn't, it wasn't speaking to me enough. And, you know, I have new highlight palettes coming to me, so I was kind of like, I don't know what to do. You know, $12 isn't terrible for the, it looks like there's 10 different shades in there, but I don't know. It just didn't call my attention enough. I decided to go ahead and pass over that one, but I know, like I said, I think that was the one I was getting like the second most tags about. So I would love to know if you guys purchased that, or if you purchased anything from this new Maybelline Total Temptation collection. What caught your attention? Do you guys like the idea of me doing the, you know, full face first impressions of drugstore makeup? Let me know in the comments, because if nobody wants to see that video, then, you know, I definitely don't have to post it. I can just do reviews later on. But I thought maybe that could be a fun one to do, and I have some new drugstore makeup here. So those are the items that I picked up from the Maybelline Total Temptation collection. Let us know what you got. Let me know if you like that video idea. So next up, I have a new eyeshadow palette from Juvia's Place to chat about. This is called the Dulce eyeshadow palette. Not 100% I'm saying that right. Has 9 different shades in there. I did check the Juvia's Place website before filming. It was still available on the website and it was $21.50. I know there's a ton of Juvia's Place codes out there as well, I think mostly for like 10% off. So always use the code if you want to save a little bit of money there. But I was getting quite a few tags on this one. Kind of my first thought when I looked at it was that the colors are super interesting. I feel like this way with a lot of Juvia's Place palettes though. Like, I feel like they have such interesting color combinations and concepts in their eyeshadow palettes. Like, I don't know. You know how a lot of times with eyeshadow palettes has like, you know, a cohesive color arrangement in there? Not Juvia's Place. They're like, we're doing whatever we want to do. We're going to put whatever colors we want here. I think that's super cool and interesting, but it takes my mind a minute when I look at one of their eyeshadow palettes. I kind of have to be like, okay, how would I use this palette again? But I just kind of find that interesting with Juvia's Place. Does anybody else think that with some of their palettes? I do own the Masquerade Mini eyeshadow palette from them, and honestly, like, I feel like their eyeshadow and their quality of their eyeshadows is so freaking bomb, like, so good. Whenever I use that Masquerade Mini, like, I know that I'm really not even gonna have to put a lot of work into using that palette because everything just shows up so well, so vibrant. It's crazy. Like, they have really, really good eyeshadows for sure. So, but looking at this one, you know, I do want to preface and say I've gotten a lot of eyeshadow palettes recently and I've kind of become overwhelmed trying to get through everything and trying to review everything. Like, there's just a lot happening right now. I'm definitely very overwhelmed. You know, I read all the comments as well and I see you guys saying too, like, how you're so overwhelmed. I just ordered the last week I was talking about the ColourPop All I See Is Magic eyeshadow palette. I just ordered that one as well. Like, there's a lot happening right now. A lot going on. So with that in mind, like, I feel like it looks like a pretty cool palette and the colors look neat and I'm sure the color payoff is going to be fantastic, but I'm just going to have to skip over it right now because I just got too much. I just got too much going on. And if something isn't, you know, this definitely made me do the double take, but if it's just not like pulling, like, I feel like I'm gonna cry myself to sleep if I don't get this palette type of thing, then I have to say no to it because I just got too much going on right now. I have so many review videos coming up because I have so much to review and I keep getting comments like, when are you reviewing that eyeshadow palette? When are you reviewing that highlight palette? And I'm like, it's coming, because I also have to, you know, try everything several times before I can review it. And I'm just like, I feel like there's so much going on. I mean, it's like the worst problem ever to have. Oh no, makeup, must try, boo. But like, I really do want to be able to get through everything so I can get my reviews up and all of that. So I'm gonna pass over it, but honestly, $21.50 for the 9 shades in there. And they, you know, the Juvia's Place eyeshadow palettes are normally quite large. I feel like that's really good. You can probably use the code and get even more money off. I don't feel like that's a bad price at all. Maybe if there was kind of like less happening right now and I kind of was buying a little bit less, I totally would have gone for it. But I'm gonna say no. I'm gonna say no this time, but let us know. Do you have all the Juvia's Place eyeshadow palettes? Do you love them? Are you a collector? And are you gonna get this one? So the last one that I wanna talk about has been on my list for a while to chat about. These are from Color Drain and these are their mini eyeshadow palettes. I've had this on my list to talk about for a while and I talked about Color Drain in yesterday's video as well, the 8 brands that I wanna try because I've never tried anything from Color Drain yet and a lot of people brought up these eyeshadow palettes. So I thought it could be a good time to mention these as well. So they came out with these new mini eyeshadow palettes. Each one has 6 different shades in there and they all have, you know, kind of like a certain theme to them. So there's Beauty Rest, Lovelies, Smoke Show, and then Very Cute. And they are $36 a piece. Now, honestly, I'm kind of mad at myself because they're $36 for 6 shades. And I thought that was pretty pricey. They went on sale for like $27, I want to say, during Black Friday. And I had the berry one in my cart, right? Yes, the berry one. Very Cute, I had in my cart. And I had hit checkout and I had entered all of my information and then it was like $6 for shipping and all of this. And I searched around for a while. I was trying to find a coupon code. You guys know, I mean, I just did the video of like makeup I don't want to pay a full price for. I always am trying to find some sort of discount and I know that it was already discounted from the $36, but I think I still felt like $36 was too much for a 6 pan eyeshadow. I think that they should have been $27. So then I wanted a discount on top of the $27. You guys, I'm just being honest with how my mind works. And then I was paying for like the $6 shipping on top of it. I was like, I don't know if this is a good idea. I bought a lot for Black Friday, Cyber Monday. Not only for me, I got a new giveaway coming up soon, which I'm super, super hyped to do, but I've been buying a lot for that. And of course, holiday time. My husband and I went shopping the other day and went to like 3 different stores buying for like family members and friends and all of that. And it's just a lot. It's a lot. So when I was getting ready to purchase it, I was like, it was like all of my other purchases were swirling through my mind and like cha-ching, cha-ching, cha-ching was all swirling in there. And I was like, do I do it? Do I do it? Do I do it? And I backed out. And literally this morning, like before I was filming and anything, I was like, I think I should have gotten that eyeshadow palette. Maybe they're still on sale. And I went to the website. They're no longer on sale. Now they're the $36 again. And now I'm like, no, now I regret it. This is the life of a makeup lover, okay? This is true life right here. I didn't buy them. I just thought they were too expensive for the 6 shades, and now I'm kind of bummed at myself because if I had a hard time spending $27, obviously I'm gonna have a hard time spending $36. So I think we're just not meant to be. And I talked about them in the 8 brands video too, and I said, do you guys think I should buy the minis, or do you think I should just wait for the Queen of Hearts to come back? Because Queen of Hearts is kind of like the most like well-known color drain eyeshadow palette, and a lot of you guys said to wait for the Queen of Hearts, so I guess I'll just do that. But I thought it was kind of a funny story, and you know, kind of one of the reasons why I started the Will I Buy It series too is just to get like an insight of what goes on for when a regular gal is buying makeup and the thought process that we go through. And you can kind of see like, yes, it's in my card, no it's not, yes I'm gonna purchase it, no I'm not. Like, I just think that's kind of like funny and interesting. That's what happened with the color drain mini palettes. I talked myself in, I talked myself out, I talked myself in, I talked myself out, and now it's too late. Now they've gone back up to regular price, so I'm like, shucks. But I think I'll continue to hold strong, especially now since they're at the regular price. I'll hold strong. I'll keep watching for that Queen of Hearts palette to come back. I saw it come back around the Black Friday. They were doing like a really good discount on it, and I was gonna get it then, and I was too late. I think it sold out within like minutes of it going on sale for their Black Friday sale, which was a huge bummer. I know a lot of you guys said you missed out on it too. I will continue to just love on these mini palettes from afar. Alright guys, so that's gonna be everything for today's Will I Buy It video. I really hope that you guys enjoyed this video, or fun, helpful, or entertaining in some way. As always, let me know what you thought of all the products that I mentioned down below. What got your interest? What have you already picked up? What did you decide to pass over? I would love to know. And also leave me some comments for what you want to see in next week's Will I Buy It video as well. And as always, if you guys did enjoy this one, I hope that you will give it a thumbs up. I hope that you will also consider subscribing before you go. I will be live on my YouTube channel tomorrow night at 7:30 CST if you want to join me for a live chat. Otherwise, I will catch you guys in Friday's video. Bye.